Welcome back. The Goa government is now under pressure to curb the illegal mining in the state. Mining ministry officials have said that the central and state governments have agreed on tightening measures to curb illegal mining in the country. It has been decided that satellite imagery sourced from state remote sensing organizations would be used for this purpose. The state of Goa is a part of this action plan.
Union Mining Ministry sources said states had agreed to develop mechanisms for collection and monitoring of data regarding prices of various minerals. The price trend could indicate chances of illegal mining. According to the Ministry of Mines, during 2009, the state governments detected 58,294 cases of illegal mining, involving an area of 8,267.5 hectares. About 1,400 cases were registered by the police. Union Mining Ministry sources say, the issue of illegal mining has been a major concern for the Government of India. The position is being reviewed periodically at various levels. A decision has been taken for the use of satellite imagery sourced from state remote sensing organizations to curb illegal mining. States have agreed to develop a mechanism for monitoring of information on the movement of trucks and other vehicles from mining areas to ports, markets, and manufacturing units. This will be correlated with the production of data to capture any spurt in the mining activity. To trace unauthorized transport or sale of ores, states would resort to barcoding. Holograms would be used for transport permits and royalty paid ones. State would also develop reporting mechanisms for traders of mineral ores and end-use industries to report receipt of ore for which royalty payments have not been made. In Goa, illegal mining has been a major menace. Uncontrolled mining has led to tremendous environment pollution, traffic hazards, and revenue losses amounting to crores. The State Assembly has witnessed an uproar of this issue a number of times. The impact of the Union Government's action plan will now depend upon the will of the state government to implement this action plan. Bureau Report, Prudent Media.
Frog hunting is on the rise in Goa this monsoon season. Past few weeks, 6 cases of frog hunting have been registered by the Forest Department and 10 people have been arrested. This is despite Forest Department's several attempts to create awareness of saving frogs. But the worrying fact is Goans are consuming bullfrogs that are on a verge of extinction. Here is a report.
Forest Department has conducted several campaigns in Goa to save frogs, but these campaigns seem to be yielding little results as frog hunting is still rampant in Bardez, Salset, Kepe and other talukas. Many frog hunters have been arrested and Forest Department has increased their patrolling at night to catch the offenders.
In Goa, totally we have got around 6 cases registered now this year, majority of them in Marga. Kepe area, Kepe and Banoli areas. Plus in Mapsa, we have got one case yesterday where 2 students have been booked for hunting frogs.
So after 6 cases, all the people have been, how many people have been arrested?
Totally around 10 people have been caught, and some 4 motorcycles have been seized.
Frog hunters are fined 25,000 rupees if they are caught red-handed. Frogs are very important for maintaining ecological balance. Frogs consume number of insects that are dangerous for human beings. Sadly, many Goans eat bullfrogs that are a globally threatened species.
They are not endangered. They are found in plenty. But if you consider globally, it's a threatened species. Because though it is found in large numbers in Goa, globally, their numbers are very small. So if you start hunting them down in Goa, their numbers will go down and ultimately they will be wiped out.
Experts also feel that frog consumption can give rise to cancer. A watch has also been kept on the restaurants selling frog meat. Most worrying fact is that female bullfrogs are hunted in Goa every monsoon. First week of June is a very important time for frog breeding. A senior reporter from Panji, Rakesh Khandolkar, with video journalist Sushant Pal.
18 June is celebrated as Goa's Revolution Day. Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia has a pioneering contribution in this revolutionary freedom struggle. But anyone knows how Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia reached Goa, we'll have a look at this glorious page of Goa's history.
Dr. Juliano Meneses is that great personality because of whom Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia reached in Goa. Though Goa's history has forgotten this great man, we have recognized him on this Revolution Day. He and Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia had studied together in Berlin and were good friends. On 10th June 1946, Lohia visited Dr. Giuliano's house in Asolna village in Kungare. It is this house of Dr. Meneses that still gives us nostalgic feel. The chair where Dr. Giuliano and Dr. Lohia used to sit, the meeting room, the balcony still take us back to those times where the first spark of Goa's revolution exhibited its presence. Dr. Lohia's contribution is immeasurable, and so is Dr. Giuliano's. Lohia launched a movement for civil liberties, which set in motion a mass movement for freedom from the Portuguese rule on 18 June 1946. The revolution began and Goa was liberated on 19 December 1961 after all the efforts and struggles of the freedom fighters. Though every year freedom fighters are remembered, Dr. Giuliano has got lost in books of history.
Dr. Giuliano Meneses, Ram Manohar Lohia's friend, ते डॉक्टरेट तिंगा बर्लीन जर्मनी फ्रेंडशीप जाली तेजी आनी हेणे तेका गोंयचे हे सांगून कन्विन्स करून तेका लावन तो गोंय पावलो. जुलिया मिनेजीस नासलो, डॉक्टर राम मनोहर लोहिया गोंय पावना आनी गोवा रेवोल्युशन फ्रिडम रेवोल्युशन स्टार्ट जावचें नासलें. मेन कॉन्ट्रिब्युशन डॉक्टर जुलिया मिनेजीस आहा, बट आमचे आम सदांच गोवर्मेंटाकूय सांगता, फ्रीडम फायटरांकूय सांगता की तेजे कॉन्ट्रिब्युशन कितें आहा ते रिकनायज करून आज पसून.
अ रिपोर्टर फ्रॉम असोलना समीर भट्ट फॉर प्रुडंट मीडिया.
In an accident at Vade Vasco, two trucks collided in the wee hours on Thursday. Both the vehicles were travelling in the opposite direction. Driver of the tipper truck is injured, whereas the driver of LPG carrier escaped with minor injuries.
This tipper truck hit the LPG carrier on the wrong side. The driver of the tipper truck has been admitted in the Cottage Hospital at Chikli. However, the driver of the LPG carrier escaped with minor injuries.
एक्सिडेंट जाल्लो आसा. तूं एचपी ट्रकाचो ड्रायव्हर.
हय हय.
कितें जालें? कितें?
हय, हांव वयतालो चडटालो, तो स्पिडीन येयलो, ताका ब्रेक पेल काय खबर ना, तो हाडून म्हाका मारलो.
कोणाक तुका खबर आहा कोणाक इंजर्ड बीन जाला ते? तुका बीन कितें लागला जाल्यार?
मातसो म्हाका पांयांक लागलो, ताका किन्नराक कितें लागलो म्हाका खबर ना, तो किन्नराका ड्रायव्हर म्हाका, तो ताका सुद्दां पळोवंक ना.
The tipper truck was plying in a bad condition. The full truck appears to be corroded. The truck's carrier was also extended beyond the original chassis limit. Dharmesh Angle, PI Traffic, briefed us more about the accident.
वो एक्सिडेंट झाला तो त्या ट्रकाच्या नेग्लिजन्स लागून झाला. आय कॅनॉट कमेंट राईट नाव एक्झॅक्टली हाऊ द एक्सिडेंट हॅज टेकन प्लेस, पण ताच्या पै फाटलो तो रॉड बी सुटून पडला, तो ऑन इम्पॅक्ट पडला. इट इज नेग्लिजन्स ऑन द पार्ट ऑफ द ड्रायव्हर ऑर सम मेकॅनिकल प्रॉब्लेम विथ द व्हेकल. दीज आर द टू थिंग्स दीस हॅज टू बी लुक्ड इन टू फर्स्ट. तो नेग्लिजन्स ड्रायव्हराक लागून जाला काय तो मेकॅनिकल फॉल्टाक लागून जाला. आफ्टर देर आय विल इन सम पोझिशन टू कमेंट.
आ रिपोर्टर फ्रॉम वास्को सुरेंद्र मडकईकर.
इट्स टाइम फॉर येट अनदर शॉर्ट ब्रेक. स्टे ट्यून्ड.